What up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Funboxing with Will. I am your host, Will, with H2O Co. Film and Photo, and today we're going to be doing a tech review on the 2022 model LG 4K Crystal UHD WebOS AI Smart TV. So let's get into that review. Hey guys, and we're back. Now, before we get into the review, I just want to thank anybody who's come to check out this video or any of my other videos. If you like tech reviews or EDC reviews, I do a lot of reviews on basically any tech I can get my hands on, whether that's camera gear related, filmmaking related, or otherwise. And then I do like sharpening videos about pocket knives, watches, EDC wallets, just things of that nature. So if you like that kind of stuff, and if you find this video or any other videos that I have put out informative or useful, please go ahead and hit that notifications bell, hit the subscribe button and the like button if you would, and get notified when I put out future content. So like I said, today we're gonna be doing that review on this LG TV that I picked up, and I recently had gone to Costco, and I had already owned a television that I had no problems with. It was a nice TV. It was a 55 inch 4K Vizio. But when I was in Costco with my wife, I saw this other television there, and something about it caught my eye. Not only was it 10 inches bigger, but it was around the same price for the television that I had bought about 3 years ago that was in my living room. The picture was just something that was just crazy different, and it just looked so much better, and I didn't understand why. And then I had never heard of Crystal UHD TVs before either. So I did a little bit of digging and did some research on what Crystal UHD TVs were, and I found out that some companies use the term Crystal UHD deceptively, while others use it as an actual technology. So as far as Samsung TVs are concerned, I've heard that basically they have the same TV that I was looking at, they have a version of. And basically, when I was at Costco, I had both the Samsung version and this LG version in front of me. And the picture on the LG just looked better. But the specs were identical. And the salesman was telling me, get the LG, Samsung TVs are garbage. So that is some advice that I think I'm going to heed in the future. So I decided to go with the LG. And basically, I heard that Samsung just uses the term Crystal UHD because they have a new Crystal processor. That's the name of the processor. And then they're also say that they're talking about the quality of the image when it's a description, I guess. Whereas when you get a LG TV, the Crystal UHD is actually, from what I understand, a panel of crystal that is placed between the screen and the pixels that are backlit. It's a completely backlit television, and that it helps with color reproduction and contrast, and that it's a new technology, but it's something that is affordable and that they're thinking will improve all high-end displays. So they think that they're going to start putting it into the QLED TVs as well and the OLED TVs as well. So for just being a 4K television, the picture is incredible. I'll show you here in a minute. We'll do some comparisons to the video game side of things, and then the television side of things. That's what I meant. But so I'm going to give you the specs real quick before we get over to the television. Usually I would show you the product, but I've already mounted the TV, so I'm just going to go through some specs with you real quick here. Unfortunately, one thing I didn't like about it, there was only two HDMI ports, so I ended up having to get an HDMI splitter, which ended up working out better because now I have like six ports and I have multiple consoles, so I can have all of my consoles hooked up to the television now, whereas my TV before had three ports. I was satisfied with that, and I only had three systems hooked up at once. now I have multiple. So it ended up being a good thing. But so that was one of the things. It does have an optical output though, which is really good. I have my soundbar hooked up through the optical output. It's got the two HDMIs and then it's got USB as well, 3.0. It's a 4K resolution television with 65 inches. Unfortunately, it's only 60 hertz. I really would have liked to have seen it be 120 hertz, especially for gaming. That's what we're all aiming for these days. But the motion is super, everything's upscaled. It does 4K upscaling. So the motion is super smooth regardless. And then you can adjust the smoothness of the motion in the settings. So I personally think that that helps make it feel closer to 120 than a lot of other TVs, if that makes sense. But basically it's an HDR10 hybrid log gamma HLG, standard LED, direct backlit, 60 hertz, WebOS. It has an NFC controller, which is really awesome. It's kind of like how the Nintendo Switch works. You point the remote at the television and it has the controller mouse icon that pulls up. I'll show you in a second. It also has voice control through Alexa that's built directly into the television. So that's another plus for the system there. And then it works with Google Home as well. And Apple HomeKit, I believe is what this is saying, is Apple HomeKit as well. So the voice assistant is built in. It's a Class UQ75 series web OS TV. So I think that's where the AI comes in, is with the speech to control volume, speech to control all that other stuff. I kind of think that that's why they say that it's an AI TV, more so than anything. And then it came out this year in 2022, and its dimensions are going to be 57 inches wide by 33 inches tall. The stand width is going to be 48.9 inches. And the weight on it is going to be 37 pounds. It wasn't too heavy. The stand's not adjustable that it comes with, so that was kind of a pain in the butt. But it was fine. I put it on the wall. I just needed an extra person to help me balance it. Basically, 40 pounds isn't that heavy, but when you're carrying something 65 inches, you know, it can get awkward. So it was relatively easy to set up. The stand that it came with were just two little legs. They didn't adjust. They weren't anything special. But it doesn't matter because I feel like the picture quality makes up for it. The display is an LED 2160p, 64.5 inches technically is what it is, but they call it a class 65-inch television. High dynamic range. The formats are HDR10 hybrid log cinema. That's what the HLG was. Active HDR, and then, the 60 hertz. So, I mean, basically, that's everything that it says here. It does work with a variety of apps in the smart TV section, but instead of just talking about it, I'm going to go ahead and show you some of the pictures here. So we're going to go on over and switch over to the television itself now. So let's go check it out. If I'm a little quiet here, I apologize. I just laid my son down for a nap. But the TV has got a very slim profile. It's a very sleek design, and it's very flat. It can lay flush to the wall. I don't have mine on an arm bracket. It is almost exactly flush to the wall. So it's a very sleek and small bezeled television set. All the ports are on the side, so it makes it a lot easier to lay it flush up against the wall. As far as graphics, I mean, color reproduction and contrast and all of that stuff goes, I kind of feel like Nickelodeon, they have some really good content on their channel for upscaling to show as an example of that. So this is the TV doing its 4K upscale. Now, this is a native 1080p image we're looking at here, but we get a upscaled 4K image out of it, and it's very smooth. It's got really good color reproduction and contrast. I just really think the picture is really close to being on par with a QLED for what it is, especially for the price point of $450. You can't beat that. And then I usually keep my television set to vivid color mode. There are different options, and as you navigate the television here, this is the WebOS
portion of the television where you can access your apps, your smart TV portions of it. It comes preloaded with a ton of different applications as far as that goes, like Disney Plus, Apple TV. You also have access to things like a media browser, which a lot of smart TVs that I've owned in the past don't have, where you can actually just hop onto Google and see what's on YouTube, you know, through your phone. Or I mean your TV, my apologies. So, and it also, it has Alexa built in, so that's a really awesome feature. You can access your Amazon account, Amazon Prime accounts here, your LG accounts, your Google accounts. I'm a knife nut, so you can see I have some Blade HQ history on my websites there. But you can access all that stuff. And then another feature that I really, really like about this is that it has an antenna built into it. So you don't have to go buy an HD antenna. If you don't have cable, you can still get local television channels here, which is a great, awesome feature. And as far as gaming goes, they have some really stupid cool features built in, like this right here. Pretty much, you can access your Steam account here. So as long as you have a Steam account with a library full of games and a Bluetooth controller, you can hook your Bluetooth controller wirelessly up to the television and access your gaming's profile from Steam without having to have a console or a PC connected, which is really awesome. And I think that the TV supports NVIDIA graphics. So GeForce NVIDIA graphics is what they say it supports, which is a good graphics card from what I'm aware. And that's pretty awesome that you can do that. I just think that's a pretty cool feature. Now, usually, as I was saying, I keep my television in vivid mode for, you know, watching video content. But as you can see here in a minute, when I switch it over to game mode and you put on like a video game through a console, the television actually switches completely over to a game optimizer mode automatically. Now, I have mine set to not do it automatically, so I have to go in and actually set it up. But when you switch over to the game optimization mode, it actually shoots up a little display in the upper left-hand corner that shows you your frame rate, much like you would have on a PC or a gaming laptop, where you can monitor your frame rate and all of that content from, or all that information from the screen automatically. And we're going to show you an example of that here in just a second, where I switch it over from the vivid mode into the game optimizer mode. I think there's like four or five other modes that you can have too, and one of them is director's mode, which keeps like a raw color image profile to the television. But I found vivid is the best color ratio for me, the best color experience. But here's that game optimizer menu you can pull up randomly whenever you'd like. And for me, the television pairs great with the PlayStation 5. The graphics in these games that I've played recently since I got the new TV, I don't know if it's the TV or just the games themselves having better graphical content than some of the other PS5 games I've played in the past, but you can see so much detail in these games when you're playing on the PS5 paired with this television. You can see raindrops on the ground, reflections of light from lamps, and puddles on the ground. I'm going to jump off and you can see some of the window signs here in a second. Just the content is so crisp and clear. Such a great picture. And I think that translates really well into the native 4K. So this is native 4K. This is a UHD disc, Blu-ray disc, Spider-Man Homecoming or something like that is what we're looking at right here. And the motion is, it's not the best. It's not as good as a QLED TV. You know, it's just not going to be for the price point. But you can adjust the motion blur. And that's something I've not seen in a lot of televisions, even the smart TVs. So you can adjust it to your preference to smooth that out a little bit to make it something that you find easier to watch. So that's why mainly I would say that this is, for somebody who can't afford a QLED TV, the best option out there right now as far as picture quality goes. This is going to be the closest thing you can get to comparable quality. Yeah, and I don't know how well this is going to translate through the camera. I have my camera just pointed directly at the TV, so I don't know how well all of this is going to translate. Hopefully, it's coming out clear as it is for me. I will be producing this video in 4K, though, so hopefully that'll help keep the crispness of the image and everything, showing you guys an accurate representation of what everything looks like there in the native 4K. But yeah, like I said, it's got a lot of features. The TV is packed full of features, and it's turning out to be a great buy. I'm really glad that I got the television. So that's pretty much it. Let's get back over to the desktop setup and we'll finish up this video, guys.
Alrighty, so that's basically everything that I could think to show about the television. So, you know, there's the weight. Like I said, it was 37 pounds. The picture quality is amazing. As you can see, the differences between the game mode and the vivid mode, which is what I usually have my television set in. The colors are very, very rich. The contrast is very, very accurate. And I've noticed that there's not as much blotching in the colors as with other televisions in the same price range that I've noticed. So basically my end conclusion on this television is definitely A+. I'd give it like a 5 out of 10 for TVs in general, and like that's including QLED, OLED, and then maybe like a 7 out of 10 including those televisions. So basically, if you don't have the money for a QLED yet or an OLED, but you're looking for something that's somewhat comparative in picture quality, I would definitely suggest an LG WebOS Crystal UHD 4K TV. It seems to be doing great for me. And I'm very, very glad that I upgraded the televisions. Like I said in the beginning, I didn't need to upgrade my TV, but I did so anyways, and it's something that I've not regretted since. So it's definitely a good buy, and I would definitely check into it. I'll go ahead and leave a link to the television in the description below, and if you want to check that out, go ahead and check it out. I don't get any compensation or anything like that, as I am not yet monetized, and I don't have any sponsors from anybody. So every review that I do on this channel is something that I've purchased myself and had experience with. So that's it for today, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video, and I hope you guys have a great day, and above all, stay creative, my friends. We need more of that in this world. Have a good day.